This video will discuss insurance, business insurance to be more specific. Think of what will happen to your business in case of supply chain interruption, damages to your physical assets, or hack of your IT system. So if you run a business and you don't have a business insurance in place, I strongly recommend that you watch this video because business insurance are not for big companies only. And today, to discuss this topic, we're very pleased to have Laurent Charlier as our guest. Laurent is the managing director of Oryx Insurance. And Laurent will explain to us why spending a couple of thousands on Hong Kong to buy a business insurance may be a good idea to protect your business. Hello, Laurent.
Bonjour, Bertrand. Thanks a lot for inviting me. Happy to be here and happy to talk about insurance for small and medium-sized companies.
Okay, bonjour. So first question for you. What is typically included in a business insurance package?
Good question. Well, a business insurance package is a bundle product of several types of insurance coverages. It will generally include on one hand what we call some first party damages insurance, which are property damages insurance, business interruption, glass breakage, machinery breakdown. You could have goods in transit and et cetera, et cetera. And on the other hand, you could have as well some third-party liability insurance, which are public liability or employees' compensation. However, business insurance packages are different from a company to another one. List may vary, scope of coverage may vary as well.
Okay, so I understand it's a package, but then does it make sense to go for such a package? What is the advantage, in other words?
Yes, it's a package, it's a business insurance package. I see three main advantages. First of all, for the small and medium-sized business, they will have a basic protection in one single contract. Secondly, they will save money by placing all their insurance or most of their insurance with one single insurer. And last, they will save time because renewing one insurance contract is definitely easier and less time consuming than renewing several insurance contracts.
Makes sense. But these are the advantages. What about the inconvenience?
Yeah,
any inconvenience?
There is all the time a but somewhere. Yeah, there is one main disadvantage, I would say, is the lack of customization. Those business insurance packages are predefined product. It's a kind of take it or leave it product. So even though there is a margin with the insurer to negotiate, this is rather thin. So as instance, if you are in the wine distribution business, you probably won't care much of having a neon sign insurance or a glass breakage insurance, right? You would prefer make sure that your bottle of wine will be covered if they fall down off the rack in the warehouse. That clause exists, so it needs to be negotiated. Or you need to make sure that the loss because of the change of temperature in the warehouse will be covered as well.
Okay, so it means you have to understand your business to determine what kind of insurance you need, even within an insurance business insurance package. Any recommendation as to what is the kind of insurance that I need, and also how I know if the coverage is appropriate?
Well, when you are in the business, you need
too many questions.
No. You need insurance for sure. But coming back to the business insurance package, I would say first of all, what is important is that you have to list what are your property and liability exposure, what are your assets, where are they located, do you rent your office space. What are your contractual or legal obligations towards your clients, suppliers, landlords, neighbors, and etc., etc. Once this is done, and your insurance intermediary could totally help you to do this inventory, he or she will choose a business package that will be adapted to your risk profile and to your business needs. Then once this is done, your insurance intermediary again will help you to understand your insurance policy and will draw your attention on certain caveats that your insurance contract might have. But all in all, in this discussion, what is important, I think, this is to make sure that you declare to your insurance intermediary the reality of your asset, the reality of your business. If you don't declare the proper asset or the proper value of your asset, well, in case of a loss, the insurance company might decide to reduce severely the insurance indemnity.
Okay, so do you end up having a business insurance that won't cover your loss? But I can understand why some people will not declare the real value. Is it because declaring the real value will dramatically increase the insurance cost?
Well, it will increase the cost for sure, but it will not increase it dramatically. What we have to know is that the property side of the business of the business package is relatively cheap. It will cost you few hundreds Hong Kong dollars per millions of assets.
So rather than to
save money on the insurance premium, better to declare the reality of your risk to make sure that you will save money in case of loss. I do think that business owners, rather than to think they are buying an insurance policy, has to think that they are buying a protection for a loss that may or may not happen in the future. But this is what they have to think first. They have to think of the loss that may happen in the future. Insurance premium is an important criteria, that's for sure, but it should not be the only one.
Okay, so it's a different approach. They should not think of the premium that they pay now, but the loss that they may be covered in the future.
That's right, that's right.
And typically, is there any risk that are overlooked by SMEs in general?
Yeah, I think there is lots of risks that are overlooked. If I have to pick one, I would choose the public liability. Public liability is this insurance that will cover your business in case you cause a damage to a third party, a neighbor, a client, and etc. A good example would be property or material damage that will cause to one of your neighbor because of a leak in your office space or in your shop. Public liability will cover the financial compensation of the third party and as well the legal cost of this claim if you have to defend yourself. So public liability is important, and it's not really difficult to make it to have it properly set up. You have certain elements to look at. For example, again, coming back to the wine distribution company, if you have a public liability insurance, you don't want this public liability to be limited to your premises, right? You want to have this public liability to be covered for the whole Hong Kong city. The same sense, if you have your employees that are traveling abroad, you want to make sure that the geographical scope, this is difficult to say, of your public liability will take this factor into consideration.
Okay. And then maybe one last question for you. I know that business insurance is mandatory in some countries. What about Hong Kong?
Well, Hong Kong, as we know, is a free economy, so there is not much insurance that are compulsory. One of them is the employees' compensation. This one is mandatory and compulsory, so every business must have this employees' compensation. Now, whether or not I would recommend business owners to buy a business insurance package will depend on their resiliency to survive a difficult time. My personal take is, why would you not want to protect your business against potential risk that could happen in the future?
Yes. So thank you. Thank you, Laurent, for sharing your insight. And if you want to know more about business insurance, then visit ORIX Insurance website. You can access it either on orixinsurance.com or orixinsurance.hk.
Yes.
And of course, feel free to contact Laurent. So until soon, and have a good one.